sake, people should know that Uthara, these girls are not just outstanding students. They're also she's also contested in the Miss Kerala first round, second round. She's very multi-talented. She tries up so many things. And now, so we have one advocate in the group. We have a law student, master's in law. And we'll also have, soon we'll have Elizabeth. She's also into, I think so she's joined with some name called George. Elizabeth, are you there with the George name? George Watakaltil something, I guess. Yeah, so she's working in litigation. Yeah. So, Tehsin, can you welcome one person? And Sudarshan, welcome one person. Kavya, quickly welcome. Yeah.
Good evening, everyone.
Hey, tell something about your class and all that. Yeah.
Okay. We warmly welcome you for today's meet. This is Principles of Management class. We all are BBA LLB students. We are the first batch of VSL, Vellore Institution of Law, Amravati, and we warmly welcome you.
Sudarshan, tell something more. Tehsin has given.
Yes.
Tell more about what kind of classmates you have, which state, where are they from?
We are from ASL. So we are the first batch of VDAP University. We are the first batch of law. So here are many various cultures from India are mingled in this, like Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal, like that. Basically, we are BBA students and we are very pleased to have you here. We are very happy to have you in this session. We would are very happy to hear from you. Thank you.
Okay, somebody then welcome them, Kavya.
We look forward for your advices so that we can improve our 5 years, our journey. And we welcome you.
So, where is Elizabeth? Are you there? Evdia, Uthara? Both of you are near Cochin only, right?
Yes, sir. We both are here in Cochin.
Yeah. Where is this lady? I think so. She joined with some name, but 1 minute.
So I'll just check with her. Just a second.
Yeah. I don't know whether there's audio. She joined, but I'm not sure whether. Oh, Mahati ma'am, welcome. Good evening. Are you there? Mahati ma'am. I can see Mahati ma'am there. I don't know whether she can. So just for you people, the external speakers, there is a student, you can see there, Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, Kathakali, some photo there. Can you see Pravalika? Yeah, don't think she just kept it like that. That is she only. She is national level, she has done amazing practice and learning. So there's
multi-talent. Kuchipudi dancer, sir.
What dancer, Tehsin?
Kuchipudi dancer.
Kuchipudi. Pravalika, can you please talk about you by yourself quickly?
Hello, Sam sir. Good evening. I'm so sorry.
Oh, Mahati madam. Namaskar, vanakkam. How are you?
I'm good, sir. How are you?
Yeah, so happy to see you here. I just want to introduce you to Ms. Uthara Ashokan. She is doing LLM there at Christ in IPR.
Oh,
yeah. Nice. Then we have Elizabeth from Cochin, Ernakulam, by the way, and she is working in litigation. Yeah. And then there's Advocate Anshul Verma. You know.
Yes.
So maybe you can just welcome them with your words and then we take it up from there. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a pleasure to have you here and we are so happy. And sir, are they from our Chennai campus?
Uthara and Elizabeth is from Chennai campus.
Chennai campus. Oh, okay.
And then Madam from Indore is Bangalore campus.
Yes, I know Anshul. Hi, Anshul.
Hi, hi, Madhi. Yes.
Hi, how are you?
I am fine. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Thank you.
Yeah, it helped a lot.
Sir, they are the first outgoing batch from Chennai campus.
Yes.
Second.
Am I right? Or second batch? Sorry.
Second batch.
Sorry.
Anyway, but it's nice. It's like a pleasure to have you here, and hope you will share all your experience.
We are not able to see you. I'm just listening to your voice.
So the reason is I opened it in my mobile phone and I'm outside. So that's why I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah.
Good. So,
yes, sir. I think Pravalika, she's talking like Pravalika.
Is she talking?
Yes, sir. Before, like when we were talking, she's telling something, but we didn't listen to her.
Pravalika, hello, 1, 2, 3. Are you there? No? Okay, so let me just. Let me just switch on my cam. So this is the poster. Are you able to see there, everyone? So, so proud to see Elizabeth and Uthara in different positions, you know. And today we have a small discussion. So I still remember them as students, but now when I see them, you know, in Bharatiya registered. And you know, in getting in a working position, we only remember our Maggie point. We only remember our whatever they'll tell you in Chennai campus. And I still remember this batch. They were the most Are you the unfortunate batch that the BCA brought that rule of black and white catering department school?
Yes.
Because first year it was like fun, all color dress. You can wear whatever you want to wear. And then I got to know, you know, then I used to feel very bad because all these engineering kids used to call them, hey, catering, you know, they used to go.
But that was an advantage too, like changing each dress, selecting each dress was a difficult task also.
In a way, it's very good. It saves your laundry bill, it saves a lot of things, yeah. And I don't know whether Anshul Verma, did you have that dress code in your undergraduation?
Yes, my students are asking,
sir, we don't want color dress, we want black and white. They're already asking like that.
We do have in our college, but we only will have to wear it on Sunday and Wednesday.
Yeah. Oh, there was timetable.
Yeah, we don't have an holiday for Sunday.
Okay, cool.
We guys have not yet been informed like whether we have got a dress code or not, so we are demanding them to put it on.
Yeah. Okay.
Welcome to campus, then you will know the heat of Vijayawada. Okay, good. So maybe what we'll do is one by one, I'll give you say 1 minute, 2 minute to just tell about you, your background, your school, your undergraduation, and now what you're doing. Okay, it's up to you now. Anyone, maybe what I'll do is I'll just pin all three of you so that you're on the spotlight. Yeah. So Elizabeth, are you on the spotlight now? Oh yeah, there you go.
I know.
Yeah, so that everybody can. Yeah, okay. Yeah. About you now.
Okay. So my one request: can you guys please turn on the video, because otherwise we will. It's like we will be talking to each other. To me, Uttara, me, Anshul. So I wanted to see the students also. Just
good.
Sometime at least 2 to 3 people.
Well, let me just cancel that. Yeah. Are you able to see that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now you can see everyone, I guess. You can see Jam there eating her nails. You can see Varshi. Yeah.
Okay, just for 5 minutes, and then you can go back to
what. No, this looks good. All of them are. Yeah. Are you able to see me?
Yeah. Yes,
any changes in this person 5 years before?
Your hairstyle. That's all. Nothing else.
Like a big hairstyle because. Okay, cool. So start off, Elizabeth.
Okay, so good evening, everyone. So sir told this is an interactive session and nothing formal. That's why I was also ready to come, because formal talks are not for me. So I'm Elizabeth B. Joseph. I did my BA LLB in EIT Chennai. So I was the second batch, and then after 5 years, from starting onwards, I had this feeling to go into the practice only. Though I am not from a lawyer family, I knew the things will be difficult to start off and go on. But still, like even my internship experience made me clear that I have to go for this practice only. So yeah, I started my work as practicing as a junior. So I got into associate, and they deal with service matters. They are taking service matters. So should I tell more, or that's it for now? Then rest of them will talk.
Okay, good. Did you ever think that you would start working in litigation?
Okay, so I started I was literally confused, as everyone is. And yeah, like every one of you are excited about this law and all. I was also excited, but I would say we both are of the two sides of the same coin, because your beginning was struck with this COVID and our ending also was very bad. So, but I was also very excited, but I was confused. So again, this internships help you to channel your path. So I have gone for internship in all my 5 years and all my 10 semesters. And I have gone for the corporate side. I have gone for litigation side. And this is what made me felt that would be interesting, because office job is not meant for lawyers. That is what I feel, because we are meant to go forward, look into what happens in the society, look into various cases. And it is interesting too. Like each day you're dealing with different cases and different parties, and it's vibrant. So
okay, good.
That's how I
Elizabeth this. And Uthara, I know you guys from the student days, okay? I want you to tell, how did you guys have fun in campus? Not studies. All the other cranky things, whatever you guys did on the campus, so that you give tips and techniques to this batch, that when they come to the campus, what should Varshini do, what should Jam do, what should do. Sudarshan is from Tamil Nadu, we have one boy from two from Tamil Nadu, a Bihar origin, a Madhya Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, care of address Vijayawada, care of address Guntur, yeah, like that. Yeah, so can you just tell Uthara and
What are the things you did on campus?
Yes, sure. Moot court, I want to know.
Yes.
Apart from academics, like co-curricular, what all you did? I know you guys did a lot of debates.
Okay, sir. My name is Uttara. So I'm basically from Cochin. I did my schooling and all here in Cochin. And I did my BA LLB honors from BIT Chennai. And I don't know how many of you had the plan of actually joining for law after year 12. So I was very skeptical about this. I didn't have a complete thing as to, okay, I'll go for law. It took time for me to realize that, okay, law is the place where I'm meant to be, and more of exploring it was for me. And even after my 5 years, I did not think that I will join for LLM. It just all came. So it's okay to not have plans, actually. And I think during my 5 years in college, it was total fun. I was not a student who was completely into like attending classes and writing down notes. I was a part of a dance club. I was a part of this. I have attended moot courts. So there are a lot of, especially in VIT, you have a lot of things to explore. But if you should go forward for that, actually. So you can do MCs, you can do dance, you can do music, drama. You have varieties of clubs. Just go in and just explore yourself. And when it comes to law as such, I was a part of this moot court. I've attended moot court, and really glad to share with you guys that we had, myself and my two friends, had represented India on an international level for the SAARC moot, which was held in 2019-20. So,
which place was it?
Sir, it was in Delhi, sir. We attended the Lloyd.
I remember. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Delhi flight. So,
NR Madhavaman and Moot. We got selected from the India round, and we had the opportunity to represent India on an international platform. Like, wow. 7 teams from India got selected. So such things, actually, moot court and all, in the first year, I would say, when you guys are given a moot problem, you will have an intra moot as such. So for me, what I did was that I thought in my first year that, oh, I won't be able to do, who's there to guide, and all these things will come up in your mind. But I must say that you should go forward and you should ask help to everybody around. It is okay, you won't know anything. Even in my final year, when I went for the moot, I didn't know a lot of things, but it is okay to ask your doubts, it's okay to clear. But I would tell that you have solid 5 years in that campus. So in your first year itself, try to explore what is there in front of you. So if it is moot, go for it. Find out what the moot problem is. Ask yours, in the sense, if you, in case your guys are the first batch, you guys can approach us also. Sir can share you the contact, and we can also help you out as to how to approach a moot problem. And all moot can actually shape you as a lawyer, I would say. You'll get confidence to speak. You will actually increase your knowledge into researching as such. So when I joined for an LLM, as I said, I didn't have a complete focus as to what to go for after my 5 years. I wanted to go for litigation, but then I was doubtful. So it takes time for me to analyze that what I'm good at and what I should do. So LLM was my choice because I felt that more of research we get to do, or more extensively we are studying on a particular topic. So moot is just like that. You get a topic on constitutional law, whatever you study in class, we all listen to the class for half of the time and half we learn towards the end of the exam. But for moot, you know, it's a continuous study. If you don't study and if you don't completely research on a particular topic, you won't be able to present. You are actually getting an upper hand on a subject, basically. Unintentionally, you are getting an upper hand over a subject. So I personally felt that, and it gives you immense confidence to actually present yourself, and your language, everything gets molded with moot. So moot is something that you guys should try, and MUNs will come up. Whatever competitions are there outside, just go for it. You guys might be good at dance, music, drama, or MCing. I was happy to be a part of dance club. Then we had this Vibrance. I was a part of coordinating it. All this was fun for you. Get to know that how to present yourself, how to hold position, how to be a guiding light to even leadership, to your juniors.
Leadership skills.
Leadership skills, exactly, sir. Yes, the right word. Actually, you will attain that, how to be a leader. So it is just about molding yourself. Don't miss out any opportunity that the college put forth. And unlike your school, nobody will actually make announcements here. You'll have to check VIT mail. Everything will come in mail, and you should have it in your phone, and you should actually check that. You'll get all the updates in that, and go forward and just take it up. It will be fun. I'm sure you guys will have a great time.
Okay, perfect. Now, thank you, Uthara, for your crisp details, what all you did. Now, Advocate Anshul Vamaji, all right, yes, over sir. To you. Just a little bit about your school. Did you ever think that you want to do what you're doing, or was there any genetical skip that you just landed up into this? Okay, so yeah, over to you now. From school till now, how did you land up in the Association of Lawyers of Indore? Yeah.
Yes, so yeah, everyone know my name. My name is Advocate Anshul Verma. So what happened when I'm in school, I was very notorious student. I am a fun student, obviously. So I always used to study less. Whatever the material, no, I have this habit that if the 10 pages are there, I'll only study 6 pages. So my father is he is an education officer. So he has this tendency that you have given something, you have to complete it. You have to learn 10, no, not 10, only 20 pages. So that you just don't learn it or mug up it. My father hates mugging up things. And then what happened is in my 10th standard, I got my hand broke. So my hand broke in this accident because I'm very notorious person. So in my 10th, I don't get good marks. And right after that, in 11th, my father was like, he suddenly become very strict about my studies and everything. And I was like, he was like, every time yelling at me, you have to study. I was like, I am studying. I am an average student and I accept myself as an average student. But he wants me to get better. And then in 11th, I thought, what I'll do now? My father is yelling at me every day and what I'll do? Somehow I managed to cross my 11th with good marks, obviously. Then I came into 12th and everybody in my family starting at 12th is very important. It is like after 10th, 12th is the base and everything. Okay. And then it hits my mind so hard that I have scored so well in my 12th standards. Right after that, what happened? Everybody started because in my family, no one is lawyer. But all my family is connected to educational field only. As my father is an education officer, so he has this one. Hello? Sir, you are mute. I cannot hear you. Are you saying something?
No. Can you hear me? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
We can hear. Yeah.
So right after I crossed my 12th, I passed it with nice marks, good marks. My father said, Anshul, no knowledge without college. So I said, the thing is only, Papa, you said that 12th is the only thing. No, now I don't have to study. Papa is like, no, now you have to study. Now you don't have to study. Now you have to get knowledge. You have studied till now. Now you have to get knowledge. So I said, what is knowledge, Papa? I studied science. I studied everything. No, I studied commerce in my 11th, 12th. What is this? So my father said, no, Anshul, this is not knowledge. This is what you have studied, learned and everything. Now you know how to study, but you have to collect knowledge now. So go college because no knowledge without college. So with this motto, I decided, okay, fine, I'll go to college. Then he always admires me a lot. He know what potential I have, but I don't know. That time, I don't know who I am. I can speak. I can, you know what? You don't explore yourself. You only see people that they are exploring their life. They are living their life. And you just got impressed by that. It's like Ambani is very rich. Yaar. Wow. But you don't know that what potential you have. But your parents always know what you have this. They inculcate from the childhood. They inculcate this thing in you. Also, everyone is born with some special qualities. So they know that my child has some this potential and that potential. My father also used to tell me that, Anshul, you have to do something and you have to grow and this and that. And I was like, yeah, Papa, okay, I'll do that. I never take him seriously because I actually don't know what is knowledge is and what is college, what fun college is. So yeah, I used to love my school because school is a fun place. I used to play throw ball a lot. I almost played 4 years throw ball. And yes, and then what happened is my family is agreed to send me in Banasthali Vidyapeeth. They used to know that Banasthali Vidyapeeth is the best university. Again, they come to know how I can live there or not. It's a very big question because I've never been out of my house for more than 2 or 3 days ever. Then I went to Banasthali Vidyapeeth. The first year of my college is, I cannot tell you in words what college is to me. College is totally different place from school, from home. No one is there to tell you that you have to study. No one is there to tell you that you have to eat. You have to wear that. You have to do that. You are just a free bird there. Still, you have so many responsibilities to go on. Also, my first assignment, I still remember my first assignment of TOTS. And then my first assignment of TOTS. And I was like, why I am writing this? Because, yeah, also I have this habit. In my law college only, I have realize that I love researching. Researching is my favorite thing. I can research. So I mean, if I'm researching anything, I can research it on like anything. I am going through it. I'm going through materials, even the student papers and everything. So yeah, in my law college, I've decided I hate litigation, first of all. I don't want to be an advocate because when I went to my first internship, I realized that, oh my God, advocate is such a tough job to do. You have to wait for like years and years for just one case to be completed. And you have just like to wrap the file of one case, you have to wait for years and years. You don't know what you'll do. You don't know how many years you'll take, your case will take to like completely complete it and then whatever. Also, I realized that civil is not my thing. If I'm going with civil, no, I cannot do this. But simultaneously, when I see criminal things, when I see criminal cases, my mind works very so well. I'll see this criminal case, no, when we go to moot courts and all. From the second year of my college, I was like, I automatically started loving law. I don't know what happened, miracle happened. I studied everything and then I started loving law. Because what happened, I thought that when I'm studying law, is like making me feeling good. If my mood is off, I just like, okay, I'll go through IPC book. No, I was like, wow. Like my mood refreshed. It keeps refreshing whenever I'm seeing IPC or CRPC, anything. So yeah, when I'm going for moot courts and everything, I just know that civil is not my thing because all that rules and everything, I cannot. But yeah, on the other hand, I think that I started developing my interest in criminal. Right after that, I thought I am always interested in this researching thing, no? So I have wrote many papers. So yeah, one of my paper is in TILA International Conference and I'm the first girl to present the paper over there, first Indian girl, because every girl who's presenting paper or every person who's presenting paper is from outside India. So it's the fourth international conference and I have presented first time. It's on electricity law. So yes, right after that paper presentation, I thought that when I'm writing the paper for it, I am feeling this, experiencing this fun, which I used to experience in my school. So I think, Anshul, this is your thing. I realized that, Anshul, this is your thing. You can write papers. You love writing papers. Then yes, I started writing papers and now I am the, yes, I wrote almost 300, 400 papers till now. And it is all are published in government journals or private journals, also some colleges journals also. The favorite paper which I wrote is on constitutional minorities, which is my favorite paper. It is published in International Journal of Jurisprudence. So yeah, my journey is like that only. And then somehow in the college and all internships, no, when you get the paper of that internships that you have to do in mandatory internship for 24 weeks. So there are a few things that you can do internship in law firms. You can do internship in under an advocate or in law institution, courts and everywhere. So yeah, I've NGO especially. So I've gone to everywhere. I have done my internships in first 2 years. No, I have gone to law firms. I've gone to this NGO thing. I've gone to court and I decided that I don't want to be an advocate. Right after that, my BCom LLB completed from Banasthali. My father asked me that what is your plan now? So that, Papa, can I join an NGO and then explore myself a little bit? So he said, why don't you join LLM? I said, okay, LLM. And then he said me, because the moment he said LLM, I said criminology. I'm not going with IPR, I'm not going with constitution, I'm not going with corporate, I'm going with criminology. So I said, okay, done. Somehow I got enrolled in Jain University, Bangalore for LLM. The full year experience is like beautiful. I love criminology. I love forensic science. The way forensic science embraces, when I write my dissertation, now the topic of my dissertation is expert opinion. When we talk about expert opinion, you will get to know, every one of you, that section 45 of Evidence Act talks about expert opinion. So I wrote my dissertation, what is about, this is opinion. We said that opinion, no? So you'll get to know that in every criminal case, we'll see this fingerprints and DNA testing and everything. So because of that, a case got solved and we got the conclusion. So why these are still opinion? We have to make them conclusive. This is my dissertation. You will also get to know about this when you'll study second, third year, when you'll study Evidence Act and everything. So right after my LLM, in my 5 years plus my 1 year of LLM, I am always connected to this Association of Lawyers, which is very important. Also, I recommend all of you, please be in touch with some association, any firm, or you may be you should also connected with an advocate also, because I'm always connected to this Association of Lawyers with whom with I'm working also. What they taught you is there are drafts. So the most important thing, you will go anywhere, you have to fill a form. No, everywhere we'll go, you will take an admission in DIT, they'll give you one form. Please fill it and send it back. Because this is online thing, you have to fill it virtually and then you type it and everything. But when we are in the college, we have given a form. Okay, fill it and give it back. So yeah, in advocate, when you are an advocate, you'll go to court. No, they'll give you this form. And I live in Madhya Pradesh, so they'll give you this form in Hindi. It's very, again, very difficult for me to understand the Hindi. So from the first year of my college till now, I'm getting this. Now I'll get two forms, one in Hindi and one in English, so that I can read the Hindi wala form and then I can translate it into English. So please do this. I'll recommend you all, as I am also connected to Association of Laws. I've never thought that I'd end up into being an Association of Lawyers and presenting case. Also, the difficult part of law, which I feel is very difficult, is civil. Right after that civil, I think 138 of Negotiable Instrument Act is very difficult for me, and I'm doing the moment I thought I'll not do it, but I'm doing that only. So you will never know. Life is unpredictable. You will never know what you will do in the next moment. But yes, connecting to a good association of lawyers, working with them makes you feel like beautiful. Please connect within, like, you will not have to wait for anything. You will not wait to have to wait that you'll study IPC and then you'll go for criminal court. No. You'll go, you'll understand the crime. You know what is rape is. You know what is murder is. It's just that what about sections you'll read in your semesters? But what is the real concept? In section 302, murder is something different. Section 304, punishment, murder is something different. But when you see a murder, when you have to interact a person who has done a murder, is totally different experience. So yes, please go with Association of Lawyers. I have been attached with Association of Lawyers from my first year only, and I'm working with them. Also, I feel this immense pleasure that because of that only, now I am capable of filling any form. I don't have this fear that what if I'll go court and I don't understand anything. Because it happened. In the first year, I'll go court and I didn't understand anything. Whatever the process is going on, they have this huge amount of papers, and this paper is also in not good condition and everything. District court is like that only. You'll go and realize that. But yes, if you are connecting with these people, also always keep this in mind that what is making you fun? What is your interest in everything? Because my interest is writing in paper, researching. Also debating, parliamentary debates. You will do everything in your law, irrespective of your personal interest in dancing or baking this thing. Because I have done my aviation also. Aviation is a course for pilot. So I've done my aviation also with my law also in Banasthali. They are offering this aviation course and I've done aviation. I have my student pilot license and also I have my commercial pilot license. So yeah, I have done that also. So explore yourself to the fullest. Law is everywhere. Just see it. You will feel like beautiful. So the only small suggestion is please be in touch with court. Please be in touch with advocates and work. Internship is not your vacation. Internship is your warm up for the next semester. So use it wisely. Internship is very important. And one if a law student use his internship as a weapon for the next semester, I can bet you no one can stop you in being a good lawyer. Yeah. Thank you.
I think I spoke a lot.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
He's having a little bit work, so he's busy. He said me to continue with. And ma'am, we just want to know, like, how was your life in the 5 years? Like, how the enjoyment part or the studies part, were you stressed out in first year and second year? Like, we are so stressed out now because we have so many assignments and all. Like, did you feel the same?
Yes, I feel the same because 12th, you know what? 12th is very different experience and first year of LLB is very different experience. So, yes, LLB was fun. In my first year, I still remember we have so many assignments. So many assignments, but the only suggestion or advice I want to give is keep it real and raw. For example, this principle of management subject you have. For example, if you have given the topic, any topic, principles of management. There are principles of management. There are so many principles of management. The fundamental principles where you have to keep your team neat and tidy, your staff, services where you talk. So whenever you're writing your assignment, no, everything will become easy if you'll do. So if whenever you're writing your assignment, just do one thing, read from everywhere, research. There are student papers, there are research papers, there are everything. Internet has everything. Just read them and write it at your own. The small suggestion that I do is you write your answers also, no, in the exam. What you'll do, you'll read everything from book, you'll learn things. Sometimes you mug up also the case name and everything. So whenever you're writing your assignment or any research paper, anything, just read from everywhere and then just close them everything. Take your pen, take your copy and just start writing. Whatever is coming to your mind about that subject, no, just write writing. I'm sure that your assignment will be the unique one. No plagiarism will be there. No tension will be there. Because this is the only small and unique way to write your assignment. Because everyone has, when you're writing exams, you know, you're writing answers. Every answer is different. Every student write the same content, but in his own way. So this is the only thing to write assignments also. You'll get good marks also if you'll do that because, yeah, again, 0% plagiarism will come and teacher will also get impressed. Yeah, I always do that.
Yes, ma'am.
Also, if any problem, any moot court, any parliamentary debate or any client counseling, anything you are doing, anything if you are feeling any problem, or you're feeling confused, anything, I'm always there. Amai is always there, is my brother. So yeah, you can contact to me. Yeah, I'll help.
Ma'am, Joseph, ma'am, as an advocate, do you feel like stressed out now? Because, you know, you have a very busy schedule, right? You'll have a very busy schedule and you have to take on cases and all.
Okay, so as of now, I am a junior lawyer, so they don't as such give you the whole case into your hands. Right now, yeah, your timing is hectic. Since I'm a girl, I have an advantage. But again, I leave home by around 7 and come back around 8. So that's how my time schedule is, and even Saturdays are also working. But what I would say is what I feel when I go to office, if I don't get work, I will feel bored. And you will feel that each time, each minute is not passing if you don't have work. So I always go to my senior and ask, do you have any work? I seriously beg to them, give me some work. So that's how you will find it interesting. And what I feel very difficult is the terms in court. Like they, not even court, the seniors, they feel that we are very thorough with all the law profession. We know the court work. We know how the cases works. They think that we know everything, but we don't know anything because theoretical part and practice is entirely different. When you go to your senior, they will start telling all the legal terms, and you will be like, okay, that's how you will be staying. And they'll be like, if you ask twice, they will get irritated. If you ask thrice, they will chew you off. That's how it works. So you will be very careful while dealing documents, and you go to court, they will tell you to do this, that, and all. You won't know anything, and then you have to go ask each person how this has to be done, this has to be done. So starting right now for me, yes, it is very confusing, but it is interesting too. Like, I am enjoying my work. Because when I was doing internship, the same schedule, I used to go at morning 8 o'clock to the office. I will come back around 5 o'clock. But it was like you will be sitting at your desk full day researching. So, yeah, I can't sit at a place for so long. So for me, doing a research the whole day was not my cup of tea. So that's why I wanted to go to the court. I want to see the arguments. I want to see how the proceedings are done. I wanted to argue too. So that's why corporate side was not my thing to sit at the office and do so. Now they started giving me cases too. So we think that like the moot courts, you will get 1 month time to prepare for a case. You get time to research for it. You get time to prepare for arguments. Nothing like that. For me, I would say my experience would be one day I was late to office. I went to office and they were like, oh, so you come late like this. Because usually I am the first person to reach the office. So that day I was late and they came early. So it was a worst day for me. So they were like, okay, you come this late. So I was like, no, the thing was, and they were like, stop. Take this case today, you have to argue this case. So it's like you have to you should not give them bail. If you give them bail, don't come to office from tomorrow. And I was like, I don't know how to do it. I haven't read the case. I don't know what the case was itself, and I only got half an hour to prepare. I have to go. So right now it's virtual video conferencing for us. Everything is video conferencing. That's a good thing for us because they will not see our legs shivering. So I was given for half an hour and I was sweating, and my senior was like, please check whether she is fainting. Like that was, she used to come and check. And so that's how you won't get so much of time to prepare for it. You have to, that's why when you get a case, so most of the time they give me right now is drafting work. So they will dictate you things and you have to draft it. So we have to focus what we are drafting right from there, because we don't know when that case will be given to you to argue. So that's how it works. And again, you should be always prepared. If you are given a case to represent, sometimes it will be like, just go tell them to adjourn the case. And I'd be like, okay, I should just say that, my lord, please adjourn the matter. Sometimes, because of your bad luck, the judge would say, why should I adjourn? Or I will be saying, pass over. Pass over is like, keep it for the afternoon time, or keep it after some time because your senior is engaged. So they'll be like, why should I pass over? You start with the case. And if you're not aware of the facts of the case, then you are done. Because you won't know how the judge's mood will be. Sometimes they will be very pissed off. They will even dismiss your case, and that's it. Then you will be fired by your senior. So that's how you have to be always prepared. And what my seniors is used to say me is like, whenever you are researching, that you so this tip is for you also. They say like you can prepare a diary. So whenever you are researching a case, just note down that decision and the name in one book. Just keep one book for it. And whenever you are researching for any topic, whichever topic you are researching for, if you are looking into a case or researching or something, just write down the dictum. and keep note of it. So it will be always useful when you even go into the job, when you're going for any MOOC course or any debate, whatever it is, that book will be very useful. Because always you won't get time to sit and research for cases. So if you have a like list of cases, that is like you're having a treasure, which you can always use it wherever you go. And that will also stay in your mind. Like if you're using a case more than 2-3 times, that will also get registered in your head. So even now, if you for your exams too, you can use that. So that is one thing I could also give you as a tip, that if you are right now onwards, whenever you are doing a research for assignments or something, whenever you're doing a research, just note down whatever judgments you are referring to, which you can use it. For sure, you will use it in future. So that's one tip. And for me, it's interesting. That's how now it is going. It's hectic, but it's interesting, so it's balancing. And I don't like to, honestly speaking, I don't like to come back from office to home so early. I sit and they tell me, like, go home. You're a girl, so here it is not possible for you to stay night. Like, because in Kerala, it's how it is. We have to go home early. So that's why they will shoo you off. After 6, you are not supposed to sit. So it's how it is. Yeah.
Ma'am, Uthra ma'am, actually I wanted to ask you that how do you do your moots actually? We are having a moot tomorrow. We are having a moot auditions actually. So okay. There are 30 people, they said they'll select 8 people. And we don't know what to do, and that's the first time. And can
so
you give us some
guys tips? Are given moot problem?
Yeah, it's on CAA. Citizenship.
Okay, fine. So have you guys prepared a memorial and all?
No, we don't know anything about MOOT actually.
Okay.
We know nothing.
Okay, fine. So how are you guys planning? If the presentation is tomorrow, what have you guys done from your end? Just to know.
Just did some research from Google, nothing else.
Okay. No, that's good. No, that initiative to just search on Google itself is good. So basically, when you go for a MOOT, so the first thing is that you get a MOOT problem. Okay, as a very newcomer, we don't actually know how to read it or how to understand it as such. So you read the MOOT proposition once and see what all are the main points that you can that you are getting from the MOOT proposition as such. Read it again, read it thrice, read it 4 times, 5 times, then you will understand what the problem is about. So I hope maybe they would have given the issues also for you guys, or have you guys or you guys have to frame the issues?
No, ma'am, they gave 4 issues.
They gave 4 issues. Then it is much easier. So you got 4 issues also with regard to that. I suppose maybe the first issue might be with regard to maintainability. Maybe. I don't know. I'm just supposing that it might be a maintainability issue. So second, third, fourth issue. So you are given 4 issues as such. So as a very basic first, since it's your first mode, what you guys can do is that you search the key points of the issue on Google. Randomly you search. And what you can do is that usually when somebody frames a MOOT proposition, it is a general thing, okay? Maybe a real case, as you said, it is an issue on CAA. So when you were reading the MOOT proposition, you got to know that it is based on that. So most of the time, an issue that is currently happening will be put into a MOOT proposition. So it will always be somehow interlinked. So once you get the case law as such, you find a case that, okay, the first, find out a particular case relating to that of the MOOT problem which is given. You read the judgment. So when you read the judgment on the whole, you will find what the petitioners have said and what the respondents have said in that particular case. Okay. So you will get the case laws that they have quoted to support their arguments in that particular judgment. So you get connection to another judgment through the first judgment which you got. That is how you connect to case laws. And when you are, especially when you are arguing, each point you can substantiate with a case law. So first of all, you read the facts, you are given the issues, and the on each issue you try to since I have not seen the moot proposition as such, I'm also not able to tell more. So if in case I was given I had a moot where it was on evidence law basically, so there it is said that whether the evidence, it is very easy, you guys will also understand, whether evidence collected by sniffer dogs, whether it is admissible before the court or not. So what do we do? All these things are very much clubbed in the moot proposition. So I took out the term sniffer dog. So I took out the term evidence law. So all of which I only constructed a sentence and I only put it in Google, and we find out things like that. Randomly you search on Google with the key terms in the proposition, you will get articles based on that. Read the article, somewhere you will get a case law. You take the case law, you read the case law, you will get the arguments put forth by them. So always for first issue, you can substantiate your first issue with paragraphs you can quote with where the judges have spoken. You need to quote the judgments, like the judgment in as such, you can quote the judgment name and then you can tell what is said in that particular case. That's it. But when you are arguing on the whole, no, you can argue a lot more than what is there in your memorial. So you need to know how to prepare a memorial as such. What you should do when you're preparing a memorial is you need to search in the net to get a winning memorial of any moot competition. When you search for a winning memorial, you'll get a lot of memorials in net. So when you take out a memorial, you'll understand how they have structured the memorial. You should put facts, you should put statement of problem, issues, arguments advanced, a lot of things are there. So when I'm telling as such, you guys won't understand. Take a search for a winning memorial of any moot for that matter. Take any moot across. Maybe if you search in Law Octopus, you will find a lot of moot court competitions names. So you can take out a memorial and then you can just put a national moot court memorial. You will get a memorial in net and then you can understand the entire structure. So the researching part, how you can do is that research for case laws with the key terms. Then prepare your arguments as such. So when you speak also, if in case you have a moot tomorrow, if you guys want, you can just note down what I am telling. So when you you refer to yourself as a counsel, okay, and the judges will be called as lordship. So when you present a case before a court, so you have these court manners. So that is very important. You will fetch marks for court manners. So you will ask, may it please your honorable court, this is counsel. Either if you can, if you are allowed to tell your name, you can tell your name, or else you can just name yourself as X or Y, whatever is given by the college. So may it please your honorable court, this is counsel X appearing on behalf of the petitioner in the particular case, so and so, if this is Kamala versus Union of India or whatever it is, that particular case. If your lordship is well aware with the facts of the case, that means that if the court is well aware of the facts, then the counsel is seeking the permission to move on to the issues. That is how you can, since it's your first moot, there are high chances that the judges or the college would ask you to briefly tell the facts. So when you briefly tell the facts, don't tell the fact sheet as such. Only take out the very, very important points that you really know. And whenever you are speaking, make sure that you take out the points that you know well, because from only a question will come from what is heard just before that, just before a question is posed to you. So am I audible? I'm audible, right?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yeah, okay. So always please note down these, okay, if you, in case you're having a moot, it will actually
can you come over again?
Yeah, okay.
Excuse me, ma'am, come over again, like how to start it, like this.
Yeah,
starting okay. Set, right? Lord, yes. And all. I'll come over it again.
Yeah. May it please this honorable court, this is counsel X appearing on behalf of the petitioner or respondent, whichever side you get, based on that, appearing on behalf of the petitioner in the case of, put your case name, X versus whoever that is. Okay. So may it please this honorable court, this is counsel X appearing on behalf of the petitioner in the case of so and so. If your lordship is well aware of the facts of the case, the counsel seeks court's permission to move on to the issues. But if I am the judge and I am telling counsel, please proceed with the facts of the case, then you have to tell the facts in brief. So remember, don't read out the fact sheet. It will take a lot of time of yours, especially when you go for outside competition. You won't get so much time. They wouldn't ask you the facts, first of all. But since it's a college moot, it's an intra moot, they will definitely might ask you for the facts of the case, which you can tell in very, very brief. Okay. Then after which, once you finish the facts, you can ask the lordship. Your counsel seeks court's permission. Your counsel seeks court's permission to move on to the issues. Moving on to the first issue, tell the first issue. And you can then the judge might tell proceed. So as a manner of the court, you should tell that much obliged, your lordship. Whenever you seek a permission from the court, make sure that you tell much obliged, your lordship. Okay. So after that, moving on to the first issue, tell what your first issue is. Substantiate your first issue. Definitely, you will be interrupted in between. That is for sure. And you will be asked a question based on your first issue. So whenever you are asked, posed with a question, make sure that you're confident enough to answer that. Don't think you don't know that. It might be there. You can refer to your memorial as such. But you need to have a memorial on the whole, like a full-fledged memorial. It is okay since it's your first moot. I guess with one night, if you sit for the whole night, tonight also, you will be able to prepare. But refer to a memorial that you will get online. So you will understand the structure. Refer to case law. So whenever a question is being asked, if you can substantiate your answer with a case law, so and so thing is said in this particular case, if you can tell the lordship, the judge will be convinced with that. Okay. So that is how, after the first issue, they might ask a lot of questions. They might ask you one question. So it depends on the judge, whoever is sitting. After your first issue, you can ask your lordship, your lordship is satisfied with the first issue, the counsel seeks court's permission to move on to the second issue. And in between, if the judge is telling your counsel, please move on to the fourth issue. So if you have four issues and if he is asking you to go to the fourth issue, go to the fourth issue and explain whatever the issue is. And towards the end, after your issue, so whatever the court is asking you or whatever you are replying to, you must tell that much obliged, your lordship, for any permission given, for anything that is given by the court. So that is how and towards the end, you have the prayer. That is what you are praying before the court. Whatever you are keeping before the court, that you want so and so thing to happen in this particular case, that is the prayer, basically. And the prayer format also you will get through the memorial, which you will find it online. Or if you can ask any of your law faculties also, they will also provide you with any memorials for that matter. You can ask them also. Okay. Be free to ask your faculties what a moot is, what, how you need to do it, or everything. Just don't think that they will expect a lot from you. It's your first moot. Go ask all the doubts maximum possible, and always make sure that the provisions of law, whichever is coming, since it's a constitutional issue, whatever is there for you, have a constitutional book aside you or have it open in your lap. Always refer to the constitutional provisions also. Whatever constitutional provisions are important in your fact sheet, you need to know that. Also, read your fact sheet so many times. This would mostly help when you go out for a competition. You read your fact sheet just before the competition also. Like after a thorough reading for 5 to 6 times, you are reading it again before competition. It will help you in answering the question. So it will thoroughly help you. Make sure that you get to crack the intra moot only. Then you'll be able to, in our Chennai campus, it was like that. You need to participate for your intra moot. You come in the rank list only, then you can go out for a competition. Make sure you don't miss out on any moot competitions as such. So first of all, as I said, structure the moot according to a moot memorial that you will find online. according to the issue, search in net, Google, randomly you search for with the key terms, you will find relevant articles mostly. Then case law searches in Indian Kanun you can do, in Manupatra you can do, in Westlaw. All these are you whatever you can use. And you know, especially with regard to CAA, when that is the issue, in live law, you have a lot of things with regard to that. On a random reading, you will get arguments to actually substantiate. Maybe some judge or some person would have stated this particular line, which you can actually make it into an argument when you are substantiating one particular issue of yours. Make sure you have a lot of case laws. So this is your first mode. So I wouldn't say a lot of case is important for intra mode. But when you go for outside competition, for one particular side, we keep our upper limit as 100. We will have 100 cases for petitioner side, 100 cases for respondent side. So that is how we prepare our memorial for a outside mode. This is your intra mode. You can have, for my first intra mode, I had 5, 6, 10 case laws max. So I didn't have more than that. I didn't know also.
Ma'am, it's just an audition. Like, okay. We won't be like arguing with each other. It's an individual audition.
It's an individual. Okay. All right. So do perform well for your individual auditions. And after which, when you're preparing your memorial, what is being instructed to you, this is how you need to follow as such. And when you're going for outside competition, keep your upper limit of case laws as 100. You need to have 100 case laws. That should be your thing. Or, you know, you have 100 case laws. It shows that how thick and how powerful is your memorial. It's an impression that you create on a judge. So that is how you need to be. And don't simply prepare a memorial on the whole. You need to extensively research, read a lot. It might be even a small piece of paper. Make sure you read so much. So I think with that, you guys can take my number from Samuel. So if you guys need any help, you can contact me. It is absolutely fine also. So give your auditions well, and all these moods and various activities, never miss out on that. It is just like how you always make sure that you make notes for moot. In the sense, you make you read out your facts, you make your facts into a simpler form in your words, into jot it down into points, and even the issues, whatever argumentations you are making. Always, I had these sticky notes basically, so I write down my points on these sticky notes, and that's how I argue. So you don't turn your pages of memorial all the time. And one more thing what you can keep in mind is that whenever you go out for a competition, refer to your fact sheet. You need to ask your judge to refer to the fact sheet. In the sense, if you're arguing something, your lordship, the counsel would like to draw your attention into the fact sheet, para number 30. This shows that how much you know the facts. It creates another impression on you. Another thing is that draw their attention to your memorial, para number so and so, whatever is substantiated over there. Then you have this thing called compendium as such, which you can do for outside competition. Certain colleges says you don't need that. You can write these down if you guys need. Okay, compendium is where you keep all your case laws, the important paragraphs of your case laws. You take a printout of all that, and you spiral bind it. So it is very useful, and it again shows an impression that how much you have researched. But keeping just the memorial before, keeping just the compendium before the judge will do no good when you go for competition. You should make sure that you give a reference to the compendium. That shows that you know the compendium as such. So that is how, that is the general outline as to what I can give. More of which it will take time also, and I don't know how far you guys will understand also, since it's your first move.
Yeah, nice. Can I add on to some points? You were saying it's just audition and you're not going to argue with anyone. But in usual modes, you never argue with the parties. You don't argue with the opposite side. It's mostly with the judges. You will only speak to them mostly. Like, they will be only asking you questions. And like what she said, they will ask you from anywhere. Like, you will be orderly preparing, like from the first issue, first sub issue, you will be preparing. Don't prepare like that. Be thorough with your memorial. Whatever you have prepared, the arguments, you should be able to speak from the last sub issue, or you should be able to speak from the second second issue, second sub issue. So it can be from anywhere. So you should be knowing from start to end and end to start. You have to be thorough with that. So that's one thing I felt to tell you. Yeah.
Yeah, just like what Elizabeth said, you guys need to have, as I said, you need to read, just like how I told you, you need to have a authority over your fact sheet, just like that, you need to have an authority over your memorial. You should read, you should know what you have written. You should know what your side, if myself and Elizabeth, I am the counsel, she's my co-counsel, I should know what she is speaking also. So when I went for the moot, I was asked a question from what my co-counsel was about to argue.
I also had the same thing.
Yeah, so we need to be prepared like that. On an extensive note, you need to be prepared. But you know, when it's your first moot, you might not be able to answer questions. It is okay. But you need to have the confidence to actually take time. Since it's your first moot, take time to refer to your memorial. Turn the memorial pages, find it out and speak. It is okay since it's your first memorial. But you should not, that shouldn't let you down. You know, when I went for my moot, I thought one side, which I thought maybe I did quite, I couldn't do it so good, I felt. But in that particular side, I fetched a lot of marks. You know, I was bombarded with questions, but I was confident. Okay, I was confident till the end that I was sweating a lot. I was worrying inside, but nothing was seen on my face or when I was speaking. So that shows a confidence, but I could fetch a lot of marks in that particular round. I thought that maybe I will lose mark in that round for a competition, but actually I fetched it there. So your confidence has a lot of importance. You just need to read so much. And also, you will have a round where you will get to exchange the memorial of the opposite team. Make sure you read the opposite team's memorial. You can take down the points, the case laws that you don't have. Take the printout of those case laws which you don't have. And press when you are arguing, if it is not there in your compendium, you can submit it before the court also, the case law which you have taken. So that is how you build on your own arguments. I don't think in most of the moots nowadays, they don't tell that you need to stick onto your memorial. You can speak outside the memorial also. So that is always an upper hand. After your memorial submission also, don't stop researching, thinking that, okay, memorial submission is done. Now I just have to read the memorial. You have to read extensively. Most of the time for myself and my team, after the memorial submission only, we research so much more. You get a lot of ideas. And I would say moot is something that you shouldn't miss out in your college life, especially for lawyers. For us, it will help you in litigation. It will help you in anything, I would say. It will definitely give up a hand to a lot of things. All the best to you guys. Do well.
Thank you, ma'am. Like, anyone having any questions to ask to ma'am, you can ask.
Actually, be happy. Like, if the judges are bombarding you with questions, that means you are catching their attention. Like, most of the time I've seen the moot teams who are being like crushed and squeezed, they will be selected for the next round. Like, because they want to make it sure that, yeah, they are the right person to get selected. So they will be asked with lots of questions. And like, they will also be like very tensed, but they will still keep saying. And one more thing I want to say is that, like, be humble. Don't try to you are wrong, judge, what I'm saying is right. Don't be like that, right? Always be humble, because yeah, they are also humans. They also have this ego and they also have this attitude, like, you know, I can't say much about it. So be humble to them while speaking. And if you are not at all, like, you're not able to find the answer for what they are asking, rarely, yes, you can say, I plead my ignorance. That's also fine to say that, yes, you don't know. Because you are juniors, you are first years, they will also understand that you are not aware of the whole thing. But not always, because that will lose your points. But if you're not at all getting the point, once in a while, you can say that also.
Yeah, that is a huge point, actually. Pleading ignorance, that is, as Elizabeth told, it's the rarest of the rare case you have to actually tell that. If you don't know the answer at all, then you can actually put it forth. Since it's your first time, I don't think it will be an issue if you plead ignorance also. So, yeah, and as she said, be very humble. Your confidence should be there. Plus, you should be humble in the way you speak. That is very important.
I think simply if you're stuck anywhere, if you don't know how what to speak and you want some time to think, you just say, pardon, can you please repeat the question? In that moment, you'll take the time to think and then prepare yourself to say anything. Just simply say, pardon, can you please repeat the question? That makes a huge difference. That the repetition of question, the point of time, makes you think so many things at the same point of time. Also, if you want to refer to your friend who is standing a position, you just say, as my learned friend said, you never say your opposition counsel to, like, in a negative sense. You always say, as my learned friend said. That makes difference. That makes difference, and probably you'll get good marks for that.
Yeah, and one more thing is, like, if you're not agreeing with the judge's point, but still you want to speak against that, just simply say, I accept your submission, but however, I would like to add on to. So that way you're not making them, you're also putting your point like that. So always try, just even if you don't want to accept, just pretend like you're accepting. Say, I accept your submission. However, I would like to add on, I would like to submit. Like that way you can say. That's all like skills which you will learn after 2-3 moot courts. But don't stop doing moot court, because as Uttara said, it's not only litigation. In everywhere you will get, it's a thing which build your confidence, build your research work, build your argument skills. Every sector that will help you. So do every one of you at least once or twice. And if you can keep going with the moot court in all your 5 years. So that's one more thing. Because you won't get time, like in the end of the semester, I was not able to. I loved doing moot courts, but then you get so much of work in your college life. Yeah, so I regret I couldn't do it much. But please do that. It will help you a lot.
Not only moot court, also you will do MUN also. MUN will also help you. Every part, every academic activity of this law, no, makes a different you. So when you are doing MUN, you are different. When you are doing parliamentary debate, you are different. You are a constitution person when you are debate. So yeah, do debates also, do client counseling also. You'll experience the real fun. You'll experience the real law, what it is, what is the meaning of law when you are doing this academic activities in your law. Yeah, that will help you to grow your personality also.
Yeah, and extracurricular, I won't say that stick on to only these debate and all those things, because in BIT Chennai, I would say law students were like excelling in all the clubs. Like we were known in every club, though our law group or law branch was very small in BIT Chennai. Like I said, like Uttara said, she and me came to student council representative, and she used to represent the dance club as a whole. Even though we were small branch in BIT Chennai, because it's an engineering college, basically. But law students were prominent in each of the club, be it in debate society, be it in music club, be it in dance club. Everywhere, law students used to excel. And they were visible in everywhere. So that's how you can be there in every clubs and every extracurricular activities. It's not only restricted to law related things, but you can go into everything. BIT has a lot of opportunities, rightly Uttara said, because she was there in everything. So that's what, you have a lots and lots of opportunity in BIT. Just wait for some time and your college will open and you will have all this exposure.
They've already started off.
Doubt.
Yeah, on doubt, Thaisen, please ask your doubt.
As the faculty mentioned that only 8 people of us will be selected, is it that only these 8 people will be contesting all the other moot courts, or why is that only 8 are being selected? Is it like they will be handing over their responsibilities and stuff, or only they will be participating in going to other moots also? I had a doubt. I wanted to ask it to my faculty, but I wasn't able to, so I'm asking it to you.
So you each year they conduct intra moot, and each year they will select some people. So in 1 year, I guess it's 1 year. Once a year they will conduct an intra moot. In that, some people will be selected, and they will be allowed to go to any number of moots outside. So that is for 1 year. Rest of the people will have the chance in the next intra moot. So I guess that's happening next year, not semester wise. It's not semester wise, right?
Okay, so the ones who are not selected can't participate in the other moots outside your university.
Yeah, outside.
This audition is basically for you guys have to prepare a memorial and all. Is all that being said?
No, no.
It's nothing like
they
that.
They just said that you're supposed to, like, we are supposed to be a petitioner or a defendant. We were given a moot proposition. We have to prepare our script according to it. We are just supposed
to memorial, basically.
Okay.
You can as I said before, you can refer to a memorial of any national moots in net. You will get. You'll definitely get it. So you can refer to that and just jot. As for now, you can jot down for each issues whatever you are substantiating with 2 to 3 paragraphs. Add case laws to it and argue well. I think
submission is tomorrow.
No, we are not supposed to submit the memorial. We are just supposed to speak it up. That's it.
All right. Then you can, I think you can prepare well within overnight also. So just, as I said before, just with those points, you guys can prepare your memorial. And just ask your faculty, why are only 8 people being selected? Because I think more people get selected.
They gave us a flowchart of every year.
In that 8 people, next
some
year,
other 12.
Yeah. 5 will be selected.
There was something we don't remember the sequence and all. But yes, they said only 8 people will be selected.
How many students have given their names?
Given their names. They said
30,
we are all are 29 and we all are supposed to like participate. It's mandatory for everyone.
Can I intervene? You know what's happening? I can see that energy is like, wow, I need to just go to the Supreme Court of India and then tell the Chief Justice of India, boss, what you're doing is wrong. Hey, listen up. Just now, wedding card is still not even printed. You just got an admission. There is engagement remaining. There is Bharat remaining. There is wedding remaining. There is so
many engagement door ki baat hai, sir. Baatcheet chal.
I wanted to ask you, how was your experience with Samuel, sir? Because for me, it was awesome.
He's the coolest teacher ever.
Okay, starting first day,
no extra marks. Okay, tell me.
I want to say.
Yeah, please tell madam. Elizabeth, madam, please tell madam.
First day, he was the first one to reach the class. Okay, we were not in the class, and he was standing at this podium and he was just waiting for everyone like this, and we were like, okay, he's like the other VIP faculties who will be there. So we all were entering and we were like, okay, come do whatever you want. We are not interested anyway, just do whatever you want. And then first day he didn't take any much of the class. He was just watching everyone like, okay, like there he was watching everyone. And then from next day, he was like different level. Yeah, he was unique. He used to have lots of activities. He used to have lots of things to say, like which are very insightful. He used to give us so many points, and he used to give us quotes. I don't know from where he gets all these quotes. And one thing which I always remember, he always used to say, don't bring up with problems. Always bring 3 probable possible
solutions.
Oh God, you said humble.
Yeah, that he used to say always. So he was also vibrant. So I wanted to know about your experience with him too. I guess he is the same right
Sir,
now.
Sir, he's the same, ma'am. Sir, he's still the same.
Hey, Elizabeth, we've never met live in the classroom in the campus. Except that last Sunday, I took them to a juvenile home where children who are trafficked are, you know, kept there. So they came for a field.
Only five of us were there.
Five of them, yeah. Because some are in Tamil Nadu, some are in Madhya Pradesh. So yeah, this batch is really good. But so you can ask them. Maybe Anshu can say what the
Sir, can you please complete that sentence after but?
What is
you
it?
You stopped but.
No, these guys are good. The students are good, but they're very great. Okay. Maybe Anshul Varma should tell what Amay is telling at the home. Kya bolta hai ho? Sir, bahut kaam deta hai,
huh? He used to talk about you a lot. He also likes you a lot. Though I also started liking you because of all these girls chit-chatting about you so much. And then I know how what kind of teacher you are. I wish I was also your student. I wish I'll get the chance in my college to get teacher like you.
Don't worry, you can come for PhD.
I wish that.
Admission.
For sure.
PhD.
Actually, okay.
Yeah. So Anshu and Uthara and Elizabeth, the reason I'm doing these kind of, see, I don't know whether, it's happening for other courses, but I personally feel law, especially during this COVID, I need to be honest with all of you. I have watched, I've taken Netflix, because I'm not mad about this Netflix prime time, and I don't have time, seriously, to be honest. I have so many other things to do. And my wife used to have all that accounts. So I used to steal and say, hey, give me for rent, some account. Then I started seeing this, what is that? How to get away with murder.
How to get
away. All this lawyer. Yeah, because I knew that I'm going to take a course for them. We knew it in Jan and March. From then, I don't know how many have, The Suit. Have you seen this amazing series where this fellow didn't even study law, but he will kill everybody in the, Then, because see, I'm not a law student. That's the biggest, I need to admit. I'm a management background. But when I started doing this rural initiative and children protection programs, I found that, I cannot do anything beyond a point. I can save a child, but lawyers can fight for the child and get him the justice. That's where I understood that, hey, I should have done law. But now we're old, old generation. Now we cannot
do it. Yeah, sir, you still have time. You still have time.
You want me to study again, LLB?
You can, sir.
It's just 3 years, sir. Nothing much. LLM. You have time. Sir, enrollment. For our last time enrollment, the oldest person was some 65 years old. So,
65?
Yeah.
My father has enrollment, sir. There are only old people there. I know everything about that.
It's still
only old people. They're not young people, won't be there.
Oh,
only
old people. My father is still saying, shall I also start doing it? He is also much interested. Right now, I come and say all the stories about the judges and all.
To be honest with you guys, since you're practicing and Anshul and all that, see, I want to do so much for the children to protect them. I'm able to do to a certain level. That means take them from the roads, put them in the house, get them food and all. But again, when they go back after the counseling, again, they've been humiliated. So that is where I want these students, Elizabeth, that's why I'm doing this kind of programs, that they get in touch with you people, So what I'm planning is 15 students, what I have, I'm going to keep somebody called, do you know this corporate buddy mentorship? Buddy means one student, one person from the law, like either like you, litigation or from masters or from, corporate law, one person to one person the whole semester. If these people practice, like this and get to know from you people. Now, when you're doing a government case, I'm sure it's not easy in Kerala to fight a government case. Because everybody comes onto the road with a red flag. All right. So it is not easy. Yeah. And what Anshul is doing in North is not that easy. Because region to region, people change, thinking change. And did Uthara, did you tell about how tough is LLM or is it very easy?
No, so I was talking about the moot thing to them.
Yeah.
How is it?
Is it like a play and weigh in, or is it a little challenging?
So it's very challenging, especially I don't know, since it's because I don't know whether it is because it's virtual. I'm finding it a lot difficult. We have this we have classes like only till afternoon, like till 1 o'clock or 11:45. That seems to be a little easy for everybody who is listening to it. But after that, we have a lot of work submissions as such. So LLM and LLB, there is a lot of difference. So for LLB, you're studying a subject for 6 months. Okay, that's your one semester. And you study a particular subject in a very brief manner, I would say. You cover everything in a much faster way. So you don't go in depth into it. So you all have a superficial approach towards most of the subjects. And it depends on the person who is teaching, and it depends on how you study also. So all these matters. But for LLM, you are studying a subject in depth. So IPR, we learned for like around 6 months, and you had everything to study in that 6 months: copyright, trademark, patent, everything. Semester, I'm only studying copyright. That means just one part of what I studied, all of which together in 6 months.
Okay. Good.
The subjects which was not there for LLB and which is not fully IPR related. Yes, sir.
Good. No. I was thinking that, okay, you know, IPR and copyright has got huge, huge business, because Sony will say they copyrighted me. Apple will sue Samsung. Samsung will sue Apple. And you can get money from both. Putting one case there, one case here.
I would. Yes.
Yeah. Why so
along many cases with this IPR as a subject.
Mm.
That's what I'll just tell one more thing, sir.
Yeah.
Just like how IPR, I liked doing IPR right now and I'm enjoying it. Along with that, we have the subject called competition law. So okay, did not have it in depth for our LLB, but I really wish right now that I took an LLM in competition law. Competition law basically means that what happens in this market, how Jio is being how Reliance is being dominant. Nobody realizes that who is a dominant player in the market. You eat you drink Pepsi, Mirinda, and a lot of things. Are these substances substitutable? You are assessing yourself. Do you prefer Pepsi, or if you have Mirinda, you go for Mirinda? So that kind of play of substitute in the market, no, it has a lot of relevance now. I don't know when you guys are studying also. I hope you guys have a subject called competition law. If you guys have interest in that, actually doing masters in that is a good option, because I feel that is very, very relevant, especially the faculty who's teaching us. I must appreciate her on this platform also. She takes every small the entire thing on the whole from the history. But I think competition law is a very, very interesting subject as to which company is dominant. Google is dominant. Nobody realizes. We all search in Google, but just like Google, Google's competitors are being shut down. None of us use Yahoo now. None of us use another platform now. We all think so. That is how our thinking process itself differs. And why I took LLM is not most of the people along with me, there are a lot of people with the experience of practice after litigation, just like people who have done litigation for 3 to 4 years have now come up for taking LLM. So all these things are possible. Okay. And I'm telling one more thing is that LLM is not mandatory. If you don't have LLM is also, it's absolutely okay. Good. If you're going into certain corporate firms, I have a lot friends of mine who are doing it in corporate firms who does not have an LLM. So it is absolutely fine, and who goes for litigation like Elizabeth, it's not necessary to have an LLM. But people who go for LLM usually have this thought of going into teaching field. You need LLM for that, or researching, or all these things. For me, I don't have basically a lot of passion for teaching. As of now I have not decided that. Maybe I don't know how it would differ for me. But LLM for me, how it is helping is through a lot of reading, extensively you are studying. So always make sure that even you learn always, you study always, even if you go for a job, even if you go for anything, never stop. Really wanted to, apart from my 5 years, I actually wanted to establish a little bit more on my learning skills, as to I wanted to acquire a little bit more before I get into a job. That is why I chose LLM. I don't know how I'll be diverting into after my LLM. I have not yet decided. It is kind of hectic, but I'm sure that if you take a field which is interesting to you, it will actually help you, like constitution, corporate, a lot of things. You have a lot of options, international trade law. One of my friends is doing international trade. A lot of things are there. So just once you learn through your LLB subjects, you will understand how it is going to be. And I think because it's online, it is a little more hectic for us, but surely LLM has a lot more than LLB. You are learning something very, very in depth. So it will be a little hectic, but you will gain a lot of out of it, I feel. So it is your choice. It is not mandatory. It is not that you don't do LLM, you won't get a job. Never like that. Don't have such presumptions. There are a lot of my seniors who are excelling in law without an LLM also. So it is not mandatory, but having an LLM is always an upper hand for you. You are having an extra degree along with your BA LLB honors or BBA LLB honors. So it is always good, but it is not bad that if you don't do it also. You can take time and figure it out. All of you are in your first year, so I think you have immense time, like 5 years. But even when you're studying your LLB subjects, no, have all the fun, but still you can you should read with a lot of concentration, so that will actually help you when you do anything, I would say. Yeah, that's
so
it.
I want to thank Dr. Advocate Anshu, Uthara and Elizabeth. Thanks, because these kids might have got directly. I didn't want to get much involved because I want them to talk, because by talking and meeting people, you learn a lot. And thanks for giving a lot of time. And Uthara said, you need to have a little fun and everything. So one punch statement came to me. One punch statement I will tell. If you have too much fun, you will get big bun in life. Right? So keep the work balance. Have a fun, nothing wrong. She in Bangalore and Christ College, it's wonderful. It's on the main place. Just go take a break.
Unfortunately, sir, this room is my Bangalore right now. My home.
So nothing wrong. Just imagine that's Bangalore. Many people say, Sam, you're in a village. Okay. I'm actually staying in a small village. It is 27 kilometers from Vijayawada. But I feel I'm in Burj Khalifa. I feel I'm in Leaning Tower of Pizza. Who is stopping me to think, boss? It's my imagination. So thank you so much for all your time. I have one last thing, because guys, you may be thinking why it's going 1.5 hour. Good news for you. Monday is a holiday. So when Monday class, we are compensating now itself, okay?
No. I was also thinking how this is happening.
No.
So then we will keep a attendance for that also.
No attendance. Why? This attendance is for Monday is a holiday. Are you aware of it?
Yeah,
Tuesday, there's a new timetable, Tuesday to Saturday. And Uthara, Anshul, and Elizabeth, in VIT, we work Tuesday to Saturday. Sunday, Monday, off. Okay. Chennai, we used to work from Monday to Friday. Saturday, Sunday, off. Here, it's
so
little...
We have college on Sundays also.
You used to have college on?
We do have college on our Sundays also. When I'm in my graduation, no, I don't have holiday on Sunday.
Please don't tell this to my students, because they also want to have class. Am I right? You also want to come on Sunday? Okay, good. So what I was trying to say is, since all three of you are, representing women in lawyers and advocates, is it true? Men think like a box, dabba. Men think like a box. I want to buy this phone. All right. So I will think of buying a phone. That's all. Go to the shop. Go to the brand, online, Amazon, buy, get it, finish. It's a dabba. Women brain is not like a box. It's like an octopus box. If a woman has to buy a phone, she has to think 10,000 things. Ayo, what is the cost? Then related to the brother. My brother had other phone.
and I'm not getting this phone and the money is not mine, all right? And why is this like, see, if a boy wants to propose a girl, he'll only think of proposing, not disposing, all right? But a woman thinks, what if he proposes? What will happen next? How should I work? If it doesn't work, what do I do? If it works, what do I do? Why is it true? Is it like, you might have seen a lot of cases, right? Because I want to link this to a discussion. If women is so emotionally weak, like what society says, which is bullshit, which is totally crap. Women is not emotionally weak. If women is weak, according to the Indian society, I want to ask you, why more men are committing suicide and why less women are committing suicide? Come on. NCRB, National Crime Record Bureau. I'm talking with the data. Men commit more suicide in India than women. But the men says, my mard hoon, my aambl hoon, I'm this, I'm that. But then why are men committing suicide? Come on. I want only three of you to talk. Only three of you.
Sir, I would like to add on one more fact. Men die out of heart attack. Very less percentage of women die because of heart attack.
You know why?
Women don't get heart attack.
Women give heart attack.
Sir, this was not fair. This is not fair.
That's the reason, sir. You just give.
You say, oh, hello. Okay, and you give that stress, then that fellow will die. Is it true or not? No, I want to advocate.
It's up to the man how he takes it up, right, sir?
Okay.
Okay. Don't see every woman as your woman like that way. So just don't. That's why you won't get heart attack if you see each person as different. You don't, if you say hi, that doesn't mean I want to be your girlfriend. Simple as that. Then you won't get any stress. Keep everyone safe. Different.
Please tell this to Tazin. She's confused. Okay, now tell me why is this? See, most of the cases, women prison are less in India. Men prison are more in India. It's a known fact. Yeah. Why are men so emotionally weak? In all the cases you see, family cases, court cases, divorce cases, it's men who first apply. It's men who first beat.
What I think is, and what I observe in my life and when I'm going to family courts and everywhere, I observe is, men have this tendency of quick. So men have this tendency of quick decision. What happened in the marriage? You are fighting and everything, no? Men get a quick decision and then has the tendency to regret also. They take quick decisions and then they regret also. So,
okay.
I work in NGO also. When I'm doing an internship, with an NGO, they have this criminal people all over there. There's people who have done rape, criminals who have done rape and everything. Most of the things I have realized that they have taken this decision without thinking anything. In sudden, you will say in the provocation or something, or sometimes they just think something and take decisions. They won't deep think that. And when you count on a woman, no, she always deep. She has this tendency to think as much as she can. That's as far as she can. So there's a huge difference where nobody can see it, but it is there. When you are talking, when you say me that, Anshul, you have to join this thing, I am thinking that, okay, I'm joining this thing. After that, I'll say this. The topic is that. But what you think, being a man, you cannot think as far as a woman thinks. That is the only problem. Crimes happen with the man more than with the woman. Why? Okay. Because woman is woman. Has a fear in the heart. But okay, what is the consequences? Man will think they will also think about the consequences, but they think less than women. This is made a reason crying somewhat and by men. Also, from very long era, we are living in the society and we live in a dominant society. So, dominance is what male people are like, okay, we have this capability, we have this power to dominate people, dominate women. So, this tendency is making them less thinking about the consequences of everything. According to me, men think less also. They don't think about the consequences more. They just take quick decisions.
Cool. All right. So anyway, thank you. Thank you so much for that, you know, that quick thinking, which is true. What I wish is we will end up here because so much of good discussion and it's been recorded for your sake. It will be live. It'll go to all of you. I want everyone to keep these, you know, young advocates and lawyers in mind. And I wish that once the pandemic is over, and I promise maybe now or second year or whenever it is, I want to call at least 15 or 12. I'm thinking to bring a dozen of people and have a heated debate on the stage, the children there and you people there, you know, and let them have a real life talk. I'm also doing something, it may be crazy for you, but I'm going to bring some criminals who had committed the crime, who went through the case, who finished all the term, and now they're totally rejuvenated with a very good human being. You're getting my point? And they started doing some good NGOs. So I want to bring that three platforms. I want to bring somebody from crime branch. I want to bring somebody from lawyers and advocates like this. And then you just sit and listen to them. Then you'll understand, Are Baba, law is not about books. All right? Your section 321, your section 320, everything is fine. But it depends on here. So I want to thank Elizabeth. I want to thank Uthara. Thank Anshulji. Thank you so much for your time. And I want to thank all the students. So we had a very good discussion. And I wish to keep carrying on these things, even though our time, see, they had a whole lot big day. They were in the office. They came home by 5:36, got freshened up, and now they have to have their dinner time.
Yeah, and thank you so much, sir. This is like out of the blue. Today, Uthara called me. Uthara was
shall I tell you one secret? By the time you guys are talking, already I got 7 to 8 calls from your batch because that poster went out. They're saying, sir, you invited them. You didn't invite us. I said, wait. Every Friday. Okay. So already people started calling. I think so. They're all from your batch only. Abhishek, you remember Hyderabad?
Yes, sir.
He's like already complaining to me.
Though I'm not that. I appreciate all the conversations here. And in future also, sir, though I'm not from that, still, you should have to remember me also in every time.
They will be there. You all, what I'll do is, I'm Anshul. I'll give one person to each one of you to be a buddy mentor, not to disturb you every day. It's like monthly once they can have a discussion with you, see the cases, what you're doing, what challenges you faced. And then means you and your buddy student and me, we all will have a 20-25 minutes discussion once a month, not every
actually
day.
That is the whole thing about lawyers. Like, it's a circle and it's about all about networks. So like wherever you're doing internships, if any people, any like high officials are coming for seminars or whatever high profile people you are meeting or what, wherever you go, make network, make connections, talk to them, because lawyers is all about word of mouth. What I have heard is like, I'm not from a lawyer family, and it is what you do is make you like excel in your profession. It's all about word of mouth. Right now, I'm very new to this profession. Still, I am listening like where my name has reached, like 2-3 layers like next. So that's how it's all about connections, and it's a circle. It's up to you how you expand the circle. So keep all these names and connections, whichever you get, and all the internships. Don't lose the contacts where you're doing internship. If you like that office, you can even keep doing your internship in the next semester too. you don't know, maybe they will give you the appointment letter in the last semester, or after you pass out, you will get the appointment letter. So don't lose connections. Yeah.
True. Okay. So thank you so much. I will send an individual letter of certificate of appreciation. Let's plan maybe after 2 or 3 months how we can bring different. I want you people to give ideas to the show. And later on, I want to have an individual interview with each of you later on. And I want to publish that to the world, because let people know. I'll be happy if people know Elizabeth and Uthara and Advocate Anshul. And, you know, social media is something which is so powerful nowadays.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for inviting us.
And so happy that you still remember what we told 5-6 years before. You
exactly. It was such a fun class, yours.
Yeah, it was very unique. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Definitely. The field visits and all, it was like fun. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
It was fun.
Good, good. Okay. So, can somebody give a word of thanks quickly? Anyone? Where are my boys? My boys. Anish, my boy. Where is the...
Maybe they have run because we started talking about them.
No, they're so there. Bad. They're all there. There is a great legend called Sheikh Muhammad. He is my my brother born of other mother. Okay? He is my brother born of other mother. If he talks, I will give you 5 pizza. He talks, I'll give you 5 pizza. Okay? Anyway, they're all cool students, but only thing is Rishi Singh is from Hyderabad. Very nice. Because the first year, they're little... in the shell, but I'm very sure my only wish and pray is by 2000
first year and only virtual meeting,
yeah,
which is very bad,
very bad, because Thyssen wants to meet directly.
Yeah, it's bad. I also know virtual,
but nothing is going to be permanent. Nothing is permanent, you know. It may take some time. Now vaccine is coming up, so you never know. And
here in Kerala, it's like from Jan the colleges are opening. So I guess
slowly,
you guys also, it will happen slowly.
Yeah. And see, the problem is, one way we say, oh, we want to go to college. And after going to the college, if one person gets COVID, then all the parents will come with all the legal documents. That time, where will Tahsin go? He will go behind her father. See, this is how reality, welcome to the world of reality. Welcome to the world of reality. Okay, so my only wish before I conclude is by 2021, 2022, when you finish your LLM or LLB, we will invite you. I don't know, God willing, if I'm there taking the course somewhere, all right, or the same law school, you will come as a chief guest. So you'll be the second generation. Elizabeth will be the first generation, because that's where I first started teaching law students. And I understood that there's a lot of homework which a teacher has to do when you teach a law student, a lot of, you know. And I don't know whether you watch this series, yeah, this American series, what, the wife or what? What is that? It's all about a lady who's...
How to get away.
No. The wife or what? What is that? I'll put it on the group. It's a wonderful series, American series about a ordinary woman who struggles hard and fights all her odds and cases. And it's all about law again at the end of the day. So, okay, cool. Thanks, everyone. Anshulji, Uthra, thanks. Elizabeth, thank you, everyone. Thanks.
Thank you so much. And all the best to you guys.
All your four years ahead.
And you guys will definitely come to VITAP. I'm not joking. Elizabeth, Uthara, Anshul, we'll fly you down for some good content. Yeah. And now don't go and tell your whole batch, because if all 120 calls me and say, I'm going to talk, then I'm going to die.
It was like, it's just because of the status. And I guess that was the problem. I was also thinking, should I put it or not? But yeah, I guess.
Did I put it on my status? I guess.
Yeah, you also.
My status will be so updated. Don't worry. 498. Oh, goodness. I put it at 512 and now there's 498. Half of them will be your batch only. It's okay. All right. So where's Ajay, by the way? Mumbai?
Yeah, I guess. He's very busy, I guess. He is like...
Oh, yeah. He is with the Niti Aayog and all this stuff.
Yeah. If you message today, he will...